the last item was, I don't think, but it's the policy updates.
All right, in your packets that were delivered to you on Wednesday, there are some policy revisions in the 400 sections. The first one's a rework of the weapons policy as far as student possession and having those on district premises. Basically, that policy was reworked. The last time this policy was looked at was the year 2000. And there's been updates as far as statute and federal legislation that hadn't been identified or noted in the previous policy. So the template that I used is actually from the WESB database that we subscribe to and updated it with current verbiage.
I have one question that had come up a while back. I don't know if it was here at the high school about off-duty police officers. Remember that, Dan?
Yep.
Was this addressed at all, or that they were carrying their weapons, but they could not be within so many feet of the school grounds with their weapon? You know, it's just their off-duty weapon. I don't know what the high school ended up doing on that. I thought we did too, actually.
Chris knows too, because before we have to make a special contract.
We have a contract with the town of Waterford.
Okay.
With that, but not with your same company. I think the high school did the same thing.
I think I changed it up anyways because the town and the village are out like over here.
No, town still has their own.
Town is separate.
Well, that'll be far, maybe pretty quicker. So, I mean, everybody's going to go to sheriff prevention just for the law center. But I think we should contact the sheriff department to at the same time.
Okay.
Do we have to put that wording in here at all then, or just
this doesn't just address students in the district?
This is just students, right?
Okay.
I didn't have any questions or concerns.
No.
Anyone else?
I do a little bit, and hopefully that common sense will prevail. I'm looking at number four under weapons prohibited. And this is that all-encumbering thing of no student shall falsely represent as a weapon anything that actually will hold not a weapon as the appearance of a weapon. So a little Kimmy out there who's 4 years old now at our school, and whatever, sees Bugs Bunny on there and goes like that. I hope we're not going to suspend little Kimmy for having a fake handgun.
I look for wording regarding that. It really talks about the discretion of, you know, the people
who
are investigating the incident.
Yeah, I would hope so too. So.
Yeah.
You hear all these crazy things on TV about people suspending a student for drawing something like a pretzel, and they say, oh, that's a handgun. So I would hope that, you know, you have a lot of common sense left in water for these students.
I think our principals have done a really nice job.
Yeah, they have too.
Navigating through those cases.
Great, thanks.
With the student search case, the updated part there relates to the canine searches that have been in place. And that verbiage is updated to be more reflective of our practice and reflect current policy recommendations. The last time this was updated was, again, 2000. And so that's, and as you know, we have at least one, if not two, canine searches a year over at Fox River.
Right.
So.
Well, I think I questioned on page 2 was if we needed a search of a student's locker vehicle at our grade.
I guess I'd prefer to leave the vehicle in there because there's a possibility that we'll have a child that will be driving the engine.
Just when I run ahead.
That includes like a bike.
Snowmobile?
Okay. Right, that's fine. I just talking.
Yeah.
Yes.
And again, I know the kind of the policy stuff in front of me, but the searches and whatnot, is it made public if something is found in a school to the other parents? If you do a search and something's found, marijuana or whatever, that the students are made aware or the families are made aware of that in that particular school, what's the policy for that? that policy that's being addressed, or they...
It doesn't speak to that, this policy.
And what, who's discretion is that up to, whether the parents are notified or not? Is there a policy for that?
There is right now.
No.
No, it's a fine line, because it depends. Was it the parents' thing that was searched, like a car or something, and therefore it falls under the parents, which would wind up being in a police report, which is open. And, or it was a student locker, which winds up being school property, and the student referred to the police, which winds up being private because the student's underage. So sometimes some things can be released, you know, and that's kind of the thing.
Ongoing police investigation.
Yeah.
For sure. I'm just curious.
Yeah,
there is no written policy right now.
Okay. With the locker searches, the reason that's crossed off is because it's repetitive. So that's why that's taken off. The student discipline section, basically the first paragraph and the last paragraph are updated to be more reflective of practice, as well as the protective classes groups that need to be updated.
Any questions?
And then the suspension and expulsion policy, that's 447.3, is updated to reflect statute. And actually include expulsion processes, because that really was silent in board policy. And again, that's a policy that hasn't been updated since 2000, year 2000.
And I'm sure that it's practiced, how I try to contact the parents by phone, but I just wondered if you could say something like first attempt by phone, and then okay. Follow up with a letter or something, just as a memo of parents to be notified by administrator of a suspension.
To be transparent that we have a restraint and seclusion practice or policy in their district, even though that verbiage was actually put in there in 2012. So it's just a retitling of that. And as a follow-up to that, my recommendation is to eliminate policy 447.4 and actually make that verbiage a guideline or a procedure for the previous policy that I just referred to as far as the 447.1, because it, again, deals with addressing aggressive behavior. And typically it's through the seclusion restraint practices that our staff is trained in to typically deal with that type of incident that guideline is describing.
On the policy, on the guideline part,
yes.
Or the PEN, we'll have to put in special education.
Good.
Thank you. It's on there.
Yep.
And then on the policy piece, I question the language of maybe a consult legal on it, that the exception may be allowed in an emergency situation. But I'll leave it as a staff member who's received training. You can use it. I don't know if the changes of the laws. And then also wondering if you should put in a sentence about restraint should not be conducted without at least one official staff member present for the line of sight.
So you're saying you don't want the exception of emergency?
I think we just need to consult on that, just the changes in the recent law.
Did you pick this one up out of the WAFP?
I think
they're
about fire or something where you're
going to.
I just think we might need to check that
wording.
Well,
yeah, the training scenario, you have one student going to hurt another student. There's nobody around that's been trained in it, and you're an adult. I think it's an legal duty to restrain the student and say get a child, so no matter if you're trained in it or not.
I guess I just feel better And then under all incidents involving a physical encounter with a student or seclusion shall be, and I wonder if we need it documented and reported to the building principal. We need documentation regarding those.
Yep.
So those are the recommendations then for first reading at next week's meeting.
Anybody else have anything on the last one? All right, anything else for policy and detail? Motion to adjourn?
Second.
Okay, we'd like to call a special board meeting. It was, I believe, published on our website and at school. Chris?
Yes.
I hope that all board members are present. The board will entertain a motion to convene into closed session pursuant to Wisconsin State Statutes 19.85, subsection 1C, to discuss and evaluate the performance of administrative employees.
So move.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Motion carries.